My name is Patrick, and today I'm going to take you along on my Azerbaijan Airlines flight back to Berlin. I'm currently at the hotel next to Baku Airport, and as you can see, it's still dark because it's only 4:47 a.m. Yeah, it's a pretty early start today, but there are only a few flights a week, and this one leaves at 7 in the morning, so I'm going to head to the terminal right now. Looking forward to the flight. The last flight was really good. Really enjoyed the meal, and yeah, I hope this one will be as cool as the other one. So come along. After passing the security check at the entrance of the airport, I used the self-service machine to check in. However, the seat selection didn't work for my flight, which wasn't a big deal because I already picked a seat online for free. After passing the immigration passport control and security check on the upper level, I found myself in the coolest departure lounge I've ever been to. These cool shapes are all over the place and include some shops and spas or children's playgrounds. It's a really cool design, I think. Baku Airport has a surprising amount of duty-free shops compared to its size and the number of flights that depart there. However, I found there were not enough restaurants and food options at the airport, and also water was difficult to get with just my credit card. There were also two lounges on the upper level. One of them was for the business class passengers of Azerbaijan Airlines, and the other one was also accessible by Priority Pass. Boarding started on time about 30 minutes before departure, and I was really looking forward to what Azerbaijan Airlines would offer on this 5-hour long flight back to Berlin.
I would love to fly that aircraft here, the 767. The A319 goes to Berlin more often, so...
Welcome aboard Azerbaijan Airlines. In the first four rows of this aircraft, they had the business class, and I noticed that the first two rows were real business class seats with a 2-2 configuration, and the other two rows were normal seats in a 3-3 configuration with a blocked middle seat. So that's kind of unfair. If you're traveling business class, keep that in mind for selecting your seats. Before I show you the amenities that we're already laying on each seat, I want to quickly give you a tour of my seat, which is 22 Alpha, a normal window seat. The legroom was really good for me. I think it's one of the best legrooms I had in a long time, and I'm 1.76 meters tall. The seat pocket contained a safety card, an in-flight magazine, as well as some onboard shopping. The tray table in front of you had a cup holder, and the table itself was pretty big. That's the view out of the window, over the wing. On the side you could choose your channels for the audio program, and the recline of the seat was also really good. There was a headrest on each seat, which could be folded and adjusted in height, which is really good. Azerbaijan Airlines provided a blanket and an inflatable pillow for every passenger, and I was really surprised to see that they also give out amenity kits, which included eye shades, some earphones and earplugs. And now imagine the hilarious sounds you get to hear when everybody realizes they have to inflate their own pillow. In every row, one after the other.
On board of Airbus A90, servicing from Baku to Berlin, Azerbaijan Airlines. Our flight time will be 4 hours and 50 minutes. At this time, make sure your seatbacks and tray tables are in the full upright position, and your seatbelts are fastened and tightened.
It is located in the seat pocket in front of you and shows the braking and evacuation procedures through the slides.
Başınızın üstündeki panelden oksijen maskaları düşür. O zaman siz yerinizde kalın ve maskanı özünüze doğru çekin. Özünüzü ve dudaklarınızı silin. Kalkma ve inme zamanı pencere perdeleri açık olmalıdır.
İnşaat başlığı karşılığında koruyucu kameraların bağlı olduğunu bir daha yoklayasınız. Welcome to board Airbus 390 Lot Company Azerbaijan Airlines.
As we climb out of Baku, Azerbaijan, heading for Berlin Tegel in Germany, let's have a look at today's route. We will fly a distance of 3,440 kilometers, which is about 2,140 miles, and it will take us about 4 hours and 50 minutes, so it's a rather medium haul flight. Right after departure, the crew came around and distributed hot towels, which were not too hot, which is good. About 1 hour into the flight, the flight attendant came around and served breakfast. And she had no problem switching from Azerbaijani to English to explain to me what the options were. There were two options, and I went for the sweet option, which were pancakes covered in chocolate and surrounded by a lot of fruits. The hot main was accompanied by some cold cuts, some fresh fruit, an apricot pastry which was cake-like, a croissant, and a slice of bread. To put on top you had some butter and apricot jam, and for drinks you could choose whatever you want, even alcohol, but it's only a early morning flight, so I decided to go for some orange juice and Sprite. All in all, I was really impressed by this meal, and I can easily say it's the best breakfast I've ever had on any plane. Even in business class, I don't think I have had any better. And just considering that's economy class on a 5-hour flight, I also say this was one of the most extensive meals I've ever gotten. And it tasted great, of course. Before we continue, I just wanted to point out that this is not a sponsored video, and I actually pay all the airline tickets myself. So if you enjoy my work and would like to support me on my journeys to get some more videos for you, you can now check out my Patreon page, which is linked in the description below, and I would really appreciate any support you can give. Shortly after I finished my breakfast, the crew came around and offered tea and coffee, and I went for a tea with lemon. As the flight progresses, I decided to get out my phone and watch a series, since the aircraft doesn't offer any entertainment system, and I was not interested in the program that was running on the TV screens overhead. Azerbaijan Airlines has already surprised me by their service, and they keep adding on top. So now they served ice cream. Amazing! About halfway through the flight, something very unexpected happened. There was another meal service. I mean, come on, halfway through a 5-hour flight means 2.5 hours. So within 1.5 hours, we got a full meal, ice cream, and now they serve a sandwich on top of that. I was full, can you imagine? But the service is just insane. I love it. Slowly this amazing Azerbaijan Airlines flight comes to an end, and while we approach Berlin Tegel Airport, my hometown, I would just like to talk to you about the ticket price I paid for this flight. So actually I started my journey in Istanbul and connected via Baku. That's why the price is a little bit lower, but as it's a one-way flight, it's still a good value, especially after having received all this amazing service. I paid 228 euros. You will see the conversion rates on the screen now. And that's a pretty good value for a total of 7 flying hours. they will certainly choose Azerbaijan Airlines again.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Tegel International Airport. The temperature is plus 16 Celsius degrees. For your safety and comfort, please remain seated with your seatbelt fastened until the captain turns off the fastened seatbelt sign.
So we made it to Berlin. It was a fantastic flight. I couldn't have imagined how they could have done anything better. The service was on point. I mean, the crew was very active and walking around, giving out drinks and ice cream and all the stuff you need. From the amenities, I was really surprised, like the pillow, the blanket, and even a small amenity kit. I wouldn't have expected that on a short flight like this. Okay, it's 5 hours, but still, it's considered medium haul, so most airlines don't do this. And then the meal service surprised me very much. It was really, really good, tasty, and the quantity was just insane. I mean, the first meal, okay, I managed to eat it all, as you've seen. But then the ice cream came. Okay, ice cream always works. And then like 2 hours later, they gave out these sandwiches. I just thought, whew, this is maybe the amount of food you get on a transatlantic flight to, I don't know, New York, Toronto, or even further, Los Angeles. And yeah, I did manage to eat that. So that was really impressive. Wouldn't have thought it would be so good. Yeah, and overall it was, I don't know, it really motivated me to have a really, really positive experience on flights. I mean, my both flights on Azerbaijan Airlines were on time, really comfortable, and the food was great. So yeah, I can really recommend them if you want to fly them to Baku or anywhere else. Yeah, down there is my aircraft, and right now I'm going to head home to edit the Turkish Airlines 787 business class review, which you have probably seen if you're following me. So if you don't, make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell to get a note if I upload a new video. Okay, see you next week for another flight review, and yeah, fly safe.